Happy Roto Twister Day. Every day is Roto Twister Day. Anyway, this is just an informative video because I've had a lot of, well, hopefully a little bit. I've had a lot of people ask me boat questions about, you know, fiberglass versus ABS versus wood hulls versus whatever. And what I want to do is I want to show you guys everything that goes into a wood kit build for a boat. And you're going to understand why I don't do build videos with wood boats in a minute here. I'm getting faster at it. Last one only took me a week. First one took me a month. And but I'm going to show you why. So for those of you that have never seen the Miss Roto Geek, bam, there's a link to the overview video. And for those of you that have not seen the Miss Driftwood, bam, there's a link for that video as well. Go ahead and check them out. Those are the two recent. I've built many wood kits in my life, but those are the two that I have right now. Those are wood nitro outriggers. And then I've got the UL19, which is a fiberglass electric. I've got the Genesis, which is a fiberglass electric. And I've got the, whatchamacallit, the Rockstar, which is the 50-inch gas. And they all have their pros and cons, obviously. Well, none of them have any cons, but yeah, they do. Hydroplanes have to be on glass water to run worth a shit like the UL19. The UL19 is a very, very cool boat. Here, it's right here. I can show you. All right. But you need glass to run them. Outriggers are super fast. They don't need quite as glass, but it's nice if it is. So I'm going to show you what goes into one of these because I am building another rigger. I've got all next week off. And barring the holiday festivities, I'm going to be working on this new boat. This is the JAE 33 FE, which is basically the electric version of the Miss Roto Geek. Okay, so this is an electric outrigger wood kit from Zip Kits. Very, very cool. It's going to be probably the fastest boat I own, and I've got some pretty fast fucking boats, but I'm going to show you what I'm putting in it. The ESC is supposed to show up today. It's the only thing I'm missing, which I don't need that for a while. But anyway, here's the Miss Roto Geek. Hang on. All right. It's just right there, but check out the overview video. It's pretty cool. I've changed the back end a little bit. I put a bigger motor in it since then. I put in a 0.32 motor. But I'm going to show you what, comes in the kit and the extra stuff that you need to buy. So bear with me. This is going to be quite the pile. First thing is the motor. I bought a Leopard High Power for this. They all say high power. This is a 3650 2290 KV red. Whatever. Sounds fancy. But these guys in Castle Creations just make some badass motors for boats. So that's all it is. Nothing fancy. It's got some little other connectors and whatnot in there. Nothing to write home about. Very cool. Yeah, motor's about $65. $60. And then we got the water cooling jacket for that particular motor so we can water cool it. Receiver, which, you know, we always need that. This is some miscellaneous stuff that I'm adding. You don't necessarily need to do this, but I am putting in, I bought some extra tube outlets for the hull, under hull pickup so I can have two, one for the ESC, one for the motor. And this is just a cool, it's called a Target Output by Offshore Electrics. And it's basically, I can stick that inside the hull and that's where your water comes out. Some extra tubing, which I always need no matter what I do. Put this stuff in here. So that's some of that. This is stuff for different boats. All right, now down to the kit. And there's a big honking fucking ESC that I'm putting in here. It's the same ESC that I put in the Genesis. If you saw the Genesis video, it's this big 150 amp thing. I'm going to put a fan on it. So this is how these outrigger kits start out. Two foam pieces for the sponsons. This is that type of foam that's on the outside of your house when you're doing construction. That's basically all it is. It looks like they hot wire cut it. This is your right sponson. This is your left sponson. And again, this boat is the same size as the Miss Roto Geek, so it's a pretty good size machine. Decals and the cowl, all right? Which is impressive because usually you have to buy the cowl separate with their kits. Hardware bag. You got your collet for your motor, which is nice. I did buy the deluxe, whatever they call it, deluxe hardware kit for this, which is an extra $100. The boat kit itself is $109, and the hardware kit was $99. So you're looking at $209 for the whole thing. But that's without motor, without glue, without everything else. But this is the hardware kit. These are what's going into the sponsons. Your turn fin, which needs to be sharpened, which is annoying. Electric motor mount, nose cone, all that crap. Here is the rest of the hardware kit. Pre-bent shaft for the tube for the shaft, which is called stuffing box. Water pickup rudder. All the hardware. I can go through this if you want. There's a strut. There's the flex shaft. There's what is that? That's a bulkhead water fitting. Water out. They gave me two collets. That's interesting. Because there's a collet right there. And there's a collet right there. Did I order? Nah, maybe I did order an extra one. I might have. I don't know. Yeah, so we'll actually go through this. And then here is the actual boat. It comes in a little saran wrap thing like this. Yeah. Long, it's all laser cut, carbon fiber tubes in this one for the sponsons to hold those on, which are the pontoons for, you know, those of you that don't know. This is the 33FE electric power. All laser cut. This will be the third Zip Kits boat I've built. They're in my home state of Indiana, so that's kind of neat. They're just due west of me by 2 hours, I think. So they're just over in Indianapolis. Very, very cool. Great support with these guys. Their kits are beautiful. The laser cuts are perfect. I've never even had to file anything to make any of the wood stuff fit. Absolutely amazing. So worth every cent. Now, like I said in a video the other day, no matter what boat you get, you're putting $300 in. Bam. I'm just telling you right now. If it's electric, ready to run for $299 or $200, you're still going to have to buy $100 worth of batteries and whatever. You know, no matter what you do. And this boat, is it this one? No, the Genesis. That one came out like $365 all up. This one's not quite as bad. It's electric motor. I'll add it up when I do the build overview. Excuse me, I got the door open. It's really cold out. So, yeah, laser cut. Very, very nice. They give you a big manual, which is in the house. I've built enough of these. I probably don't need the manual, but I'll read it anyway just because it's electric and I haven't done the electric ones. I call this a scratch build kit. Real diehard boat guys, you know, the guys that are been building boats, you know, they do it every day or whatever, they'll be like, no, it's not. Scratch built's when you take blueprints and you lay them over wood and you cut the wood yourself, and never gonna fucking happen. This is scratch built enough for me, right? You know, fucking glue and everything else. And that's the other thing. You need CA glue. You need medium CA glue is what I use. Activator, which comes in handy, and you don't have to use CA, but you need 6-minute epoxy, you need 30 minutes epoxy, and you need finishing resin or finishing epoxy. There's a lot of peripheral, and then you got to count all the cups, and you got to count all the little brushes and all the little ancillary bullshit. I would say with finishing resin, it's probably not real out of whack to assume that you're going to spend $80 in nothing but glue, popsicle sticks, and Dixie cups. And I'm not fucking kidding, right? And I might do a little part of this build on video just so you guys can see what it's about. But as you can see, they don't give you a lot of, you know, there's no head start here. It's pretty fucking scratch built in JJ terms, okay? So here's what comes in the hardware kit. This is the prop. Go ahead and open this up so you can see it. And these are copper props, copper brass, whatever. There is no beryllium in these. Oh, runny nose. Velcro for battery straps, which I won't be using. All sorts of little goodies in here. Servo mounts, aluminum, which is cool. Little bearing, thrust bearing for the motors, I think, which we probably won't use. Collet for your flex shaft, going to your motor, all that good stuff. Water water through bulkhead fitting. So this is going to go through the bulkhead to connect your water lines. And this is going to be your water out when it spits out of the hull for the water cooling, which I will not be using because I bought that fancy one that has two in it. And a bunch of miscellaneous screws and other bullshit. Let's see, what else? This, wow, they gave you a servo with this thing? I'll be damned. Servo. I am impressed. That is really cool. And I know you guys are like, really? Whoop-de-doo. And that's not a metal, at least it doesn't look like a Metal Gear servo, but it is a servo, comes with servo wheels. I'm going to be using one of my 20 kilogram Metal Gears that are waterproof. But, and this might be waterproof to boat servo, so, you know, whatever. But this is your hardware for your stinger, you know, that holds your prop shaft there, all sorts of goodies in here. Go through rudders and all that. They give you silicon tubing, which I always need. And this is your pre-bent tube shaft, your rudder arm in there, and then your flex shaft is in here too. So when you spend that $100, and I do recommend if you guys do a kit like this from Zip Kits, especially Zip Kits, and that's why I like Zip Kits, because most places you order the, most places, maybe not all, but most places you order the boat kit and all this is the boat, you know, and then you're kind of on your own to sort out what the best flavors are for the hardware, and then you end up paying more because you're buying it piece by piece. With Zip Kits, they've already done the work for you, and I'm not plugging them. I mean, I don't know the guys or anything, but I can say it's worth the money. It's a very good kit. If you spend the extra money to get the deluxe hardware sets for these things, which I've done on all three boats, I have had absolutely everything I've needed. I have not needed or for want anything at all. And that's nice. It takes a lot of the guesswork out of it. It's like, oh, do I, what kind of stinger size do I use? What kind of prop shaft do I use? How do I bend the shaft, the tube, you know, the stuffing box, all that crap. You don't have to fuck around with that. It's really nice. It's just right there, $200 in this case. The Driftwood, which is the stained outrigger I built the other day that I showed you guys, that one was even cheaper. That boat was $69 and the hardware kit for it was $99. So $169 you can have that boat, but then you need a nitro engine and a servo radio, but that's really about it. Because even with that, the nitro deluxe kits come with the gas tank, they come with the tubing, they come with everything you need. The epoxies are what get you too, you know, because you're paying $7, $12 for 6 minute, you're paying $12 for 30 minute, you're paying, I pay by the gallons of the big finishing resin, so those are $60, but it's a gallon, it lasts you for, you know, 20 boats, but, so yeah, you know, all that little ancillary bullshit, it's like Bardwell buying electrical tape, it's just tons of stuff, so, but believe it or not, it's not that hard to build, and the whole point of this video, and yes, there is a point to this video, is should you go this route, or should you, you know, buy a ready to run, like the hydroplane up there, the Genesis definitely was not ready to run, or whatever, you know, whatever boats you guys are out there, you know, I'm a big fan of Pro Boat, Aquacraft, I like the UL1, that's about it, which I will have one of those, I like that, it's basically the same thing as the Pro Boat UL19, but a little bit different, yeah, so, you know, which do you do? A lot of people, especially after watching this fucking video, when you see all that crap, it is a lot of work. I'm not going to lie to you. This is not something you're going to sit down in an afternoon, probably, and get done. This one I'm going to build a little bit differently. I'll bet you I get it done in about 3 days, not counting the finish. But just because I'm going to try a trick and hopefully it works and I don't fuck it up. But here's my point on this. The directions are pretty good for these things, but they're not perfect. They're written by Americans. There's no Jinglish, none of that stuff. But they do leave certain little things out of the manuals that I think they probably take for granted, and I take for granted even because I've built so many boats and I don't even think about it. I just look at the order stuff goes in and I put it all together, but I'm used to it. Where somebody's doing it for the first time, you might have to really kind of sit and think, they never said to do this, but I know I have to, you know, but it's not a big deal at all. And these guys have been very receptive. I've emailed them a couple times on some questions. They've been great getting back to me, and they don't know who the hell I am, obviously. So my point being, I'm finally getting to the fucking point. My point being is if you like building, really building. I mean, a lot of guys, like I said in my quad videos, you know, there's guys that love to fly, there's guys that love to build, and there's guys that love both, okay? My brother Shiloh doesn't like building. He just likes to take his bird out there and go flying. I've got other friends that only like building, like Ted, and they don't even fly the fucking things. They just sell them or do whatever they do. You gotta like building for something like this. It's really, the best I can associate it to is probably like when you're a kid and you're building plastic model cars, or you're building plastic model airplanes, or, you know, if you did stick build airplanes and things like that. It's very, very fun. It's relaxing to do. It's not really that fucking stressful at all. It's pretty common sense, a lot of it. But if you really enjoy, especially this winter, you know, like right now, it's not that cold, but it's pouring and it's just shitty out. It's a great thing to do in the house. Put a cloth down on your table, sit there with some epoxy, and just all the family's watching TV, work on your boat. If you're into that, if you're into building intricate, and it's not even that intricate, I think, my own opinion, an outrigger is probably one of the easiest boat bodies to build, and oddly enough, it's the fastest. Hydroplanes are probably second fastest hull. Those are harder to build. There's a lot more curvature to them, there's a lot more ribs in them, and all these other crazy things, whereas an outrigger is very straightforward. It's not hard. V-hulls, I think, are more artistic than hard. You know, to do a V, which I'm going to do a V next. And it probably won't be till the end of winter. This is my last boat build for a little while. I always say that. I'll probably build another one next week. But I'm going to build a gas, like the big rock star, only it's going to be a V hull. And I have a hydroplane coming for my buddy Lincoln David. I sent him my, remember the Miss Budweiser? I sent that fiberglass hydroplane hull down to Carolina. My buddy Lincoln is, he's already got it primed and set. I think he's painting it this week. And hopefully that will come back within the next week or two. And we're going to go ahead and do a build video on that old hydro. That's more of a restoration project than it is a build. But yeah, I think if you... For as cheap as these kits are, and especially like if you build the Driftwood, you know, the other rigger that I did, it's a $69 kit. And even this one's $100. And you don't have to do it all at once. And you could go out and buy the kit, buy the hardware kit, and build it nice and slow and take your time and save up money for the motor, save up money for the ESC or whatever. It's pretty cool. But it's not labor intensive. You don't need special tools. You don't need huge table clamps. You do need a lot of little bullshit clamps like, you know, Menards and stuff maybe, but you don't need any fancy woodwork and stuff. It helps if you have some, like I've got a big desk belt sander and things like that, comes in really handy. But that is what one of those kits looks like in a billion pieces, and I'm going to try to do some part of it on video just so you can see the epoxying process and things like that. I don't know if I'll get around to it, and that boat's also getting hydro dipped, so it's going to be cool. But yeah, I just wanted to give you guys that are thinking about it, thinking about doing a kit, check out zipkits.com. It's ZIPPKITS, one word, .com. Excuse me. There's a bunch of guys out there, but I think Zipkits is probably the best value. I order shit, I get 3 days, 2 days. And it's really, I know value when it comes to RC stuff. And I look at the components, they're very solid components. The hardware's nice. Everything's cool. I wish they would go metric and everything. They have it on their standard as far as screws, but you know, whatever, it's an American thing. But America should be metric too, so whatever. So anyway, keep the dry side up, kids. If you want to build a boat, please ask any questions you want. I will be glad to help you out. I have some quad stuff coming up tonight and tomorrow. I got the Mocha Gravity frames in. Whew, I got the 3-inch and the 7-inch. We're going to review those. I'm going to build the 3-inch. It's not going to be a build video probably because it's just more of the same. But it's going to be cool nonetheless. And we'll review it and you guys can see the folding Mocha Gravity headhunters. And it's going to be really, really cool. And I think there's some campfire quads coming too. So anyway, kids, keep shiny side up. Talk to you later. Bye. Gangnam Style. Oh, oh.